There are many variations of using textures to modify the surface's parameters in the lighting equation. Another way to vary the surface while calculating illumination is to apply textures as light sources. We've seen how a skybox can be made to surround a scene. An extremely clever technique is to have surfaces reflect a skybox. This technique is called reflection mapping, or sometimes environment mapping. The basic idea is to make one object surrounding the world something that other objects can reflect. This is called the environment map. The illumination process is a bit like ray tracing, where a ray is reflected off a shiny surface and picks up color of any reflected objects. The difference is that there's only one simple object to reflect, typically a cube map. Unlike a skybox, the environment map is used only when a shiny surface needs a reflected color. You can certainly also put a skybox in a scene using the same cube map. This is commonly done in order to produce a convincing effect. However, the environment map is a separate object that is part of the shiny object's material description. That said, skyboxes and reflection maps work using the same idea. You can think of a skybox as a physical object, which is what we usually do, or you can think of it as a texture function. What is the color of the skybox in the direction the eye is looking? An environment map is exactly the same, only for reflected rays. What is the color of the environment map in the reflected direction? How it works is this. We render a fragment on a reflective surface, such as a sphere. We compute the usual elements as desired, such as diffuse, ambient, and so on. For the environment map, we also need the direction to the eye and the shading normal at the fragment. These two vectors are used to compute the reflection direction, which is then used to find the texel on our environment map. This texel color can then be blended into the final color of the fragment. The color from the reflection map makes the surface appear mirror-like. The very simplest cube map to reflect is one that's at infinity. Remember how a directional light came from a certain direction but was considered infinitely far away? Directional lights are inexpensive to use because their direction vector never changes for any surface. Similarly, if you define an environment map as being at infinity, you're saying that no matter where I am in my virtual world, when I look a certain direction, I want to always get the same color back from my environment map. To sum up, the reflection direction is computed for a reflective surface, and this direction is then used to access the environment map. This algorithm has limitations somewhat the reverse of the skybox. The reflected objects are always seen as being infinitely far away. For example, say you have a reflective sphere in a room represented by an environment map in a skybox. If you move the sphere from the center of the room to near a wall, the reflection of the wall will not look closer. That said, reflection mapping is an inexpensive way to add convincing visual detail to a model. Our eyes are usually not very good at reversing the process of reflection. We see something reflected and our brains interpret the object we're viewing as being shiny. We don't waste brain power trying to figure out if the reflections are perfectly correct, since in the real world they always are.